The race to net zero is on, and heat pumps are set to play a big part in the future of home heating in the UK.
Right now, there are less than a million heat pumps heating homes across the UK, which is tiny when compared to the roughly 23 million gas boilers in people's homes.
But as we move away from gas for our heating, that's set to change. Heat pumps are a proven technology and are used around the world. Governments across the UK are now promoting heat pumps and have targets for ramping up the number of installations in the next few years.
If you look at the news, lots of people are talking about heat pumps. It's being written about in the papers, so there's definitely a lot of interest from consumers. Some of the engineers I know that are already in the heat pump game are inundated with work, and obviously the engineers I speak to that are maybe just doing gas at the moment are realising there's an emerging market opening for them.
So if you're an existing heating engineer, there's never been a better time to retrain to become a heat pump installer. Across the UK, there are millions of homes that will need to be converted to use heat pumps. As a heating engineer, you already have the knowledge and experience to quickly upskill and install heat pumps.
It's just tweaking of learning. It's nothing sort of revolutionary. There are a few calculations to do sort of beforehand that you're kind of taught a lot of it anyway. It's just a with having a low temperature system, it's just a slightly different way of thinking about it. With a gas engineer, a gas boiler is your heat source. With a heat pump engineer, the heat pump is your heat source.
Becoming an installer can also be a rewarding and long-term career path with a good salary and prospects.
There's definitely lots of work in heat pumps. I mean, the engineers that are already installing heat pumps are turning customers away. You know, there's so much work coming in. For many out there, transitioning it does look quite an attractive proposition for them. It can be quite nerve-wracking sort of changing your business model a little bit from what you currently do, especially if it's a successful business. But it's definitely the future, and so, you know, learning from your peers, getting into conversations is a great way to sort of understand a lot more about the technology.
So you want to become a heat pump installer. Anyone with the right technical skills can install heat pumps. But if you want to work in retrofit, that's replacing heating systems in existing homes, you need to be affiliated with the Micro Generation Certification Scheme, or MCS. MCS is an independent scheme that certifies installers of renewable energy technologies such as heat pumps. It exists to ensure quality installations and to provide consumer protection. In retrofit, only householders who use MCS-certified installers can access the £5,000 grant offered by the Boiler Upgrade Scheme in England and Wales, or the grants and interest-free loans available for domestic heat pump installations in existing buildings in Scotland. This means that most consumers will only buy a heat pump from an installer affiliated with MCS. You now have a choice between three main routes to becoming MCS-affiliated. You could join an MCS umbrella scheme, or you could become an employee of an MCS-certified installation business, or lastly, you could become a fully MCS-certified heat pump installer, heating system designer, or both.
You can then run your own heat pump business.
Let's look at each of those routes in more detail. Joining an MCS umbrella scheme may be the easiest way for sole traders and micro-businesses to begin installing heat pumps.
So umbrella scheme is a company who will take on part of your work that either you can't do or you haven't got time to do. So for example, there are MCS umbrella schemes where companies will take on your installations and make them MCS accredited. Another type of company, you can have your heat loss done, and you can even have system design done by other companies. So they will literally just scoop that side out for you if all you want to do is the installation.
Other advantages of joining an umbrella scheme are, you can offer your customers the government-backed grants and loans. It's quick and easy to join. They provide all the training needed. They will also provide you with a steady stream of installations, and there's far less paperwork involved. But on the other hand, you will likely only earn a day rate or have to pay a fee to the umbrella scheme operator. You will also be reliant on another business to provide you with leads, and you'll have less control over the work you do. Similar to joining an umbrella scheme, becoming an employee of an MCS certified installation business means you won't need to go through the certification process yourself. There are lots of different types of business that you might be employed in.
You've got your sole traders, so that, you know, a couple of guys who are coming together to thrash out heat pump install. Then you've got your small to medium businesses, so like the one that I work for, with a team of people behind them, but they're still a small business, you know the boss basically. And then you've got your big players. I mean, they're huge companies, but with that you do have security and, you know, all the benefits that there are from working for a larger company.
The exact steps you need to follow to join an MCS certified business depend on the requirements for the role. There are a couple of things you should typically expect, however. A company may be looking to hire a competent gas or oil engineer and plumber who doesn't have experience in heat pumps. The company will then likely provide you with training and support. Some companies may expect that you have some knowledge of heat pumps. You may, for example, have completed a training course or have some direct work experience. So the advantages of becoming an employee of an MCS certified installation business include: you don't need to go through the MCS certification process yourself. It could be less costly, as the company may sponsor some of the training. It'll also provide a stable salary and fewer risks. But on the negative side, it may mean less control over your job and schedule, and you will probably earn a lower salary than if you worked as a sole trader. Becoming an MCS certified installer and designer is the best route if you want to focus solely on heat pumps and are looking to set up your own business. For gas engineers based in Scotland, there is funding available to become MCS certified through the MCS Certification Fund. There may be other schemes available locally elsewhere in the UK too.
The first thing I always advise anyone to do is to go on the MCS website, have a really, really good dig around, spend, you know, a good couple of days digging around that website. On their site, it will tell you the process and the steps to become MCS certified. And one of the things you will need to do is register with a certification body that is recognised for being part of the MCS scheme. So they're going to be providing you information, and then now they're going to be the ones telling you what your next steps are.
While your MCS certification body will provide you with detailed information, broadly, these are the things you'll need to do: attend an approved heat pump training course, register with a consumer code, choose a quality management system, fit a heat pump, and have your office and installation inspected by an assessor. So the advantages of becoming MCS approved include the ability to offer the Boiler Upgrade Scheme grant and Home Energy Scotland loan to customers. You'll have complete control of the process from start to finish, and you'll benefit from higher profit margins than in the fossil fuel boiler industry. However, becoming MCS approved takes time to do and requires a lot of administrative work. It also costs just over £2,000 to become approved, and there will be an ongoing annual inspection. One last thing to consider is that MCS has split the certification for designing and installing heat pumps. This means you can choose to become certified in just one of the two, or you can choose to do both. If you do only one, you can partner with another colleague who's certified in the other. Unless both the system designer and the installer are MCS certified, you won't be able to offer the government incentive schemes, which are worth at least £5,000 to consumers. It may seem complicated at first, but installing heat pumps is an attractive career path. It's a growing industry, and demand is only set to increase in the coming years.
If you sort of transition to sort of the heat pump sort of game, and you're putting in systems that are keeping people warm, and you can visually see that they're very excited about their new system and they're very complimentary, you know, that's one of the rewarding aspects of the job.
My top tip is don't be afraid. Don't be afraid, and don't be dismissive. They're my two main things, because basically, if you're a good gas heating engineer, you will be a good heat pump heating engineer.